Welcome to another video of the How to MQTT series. In the last videos of MQTT series, we learned what is MQTT, how to make MQTT broker using Raspberry Pi, how we can use local MQTT broker to make a connection between ESP8266 and Raspberry Pi. In this video, we will do the same thing, which we did last time. But we will use cloud instead of a local MQTT broker. The links of the former videos will be in description. Before starting, I would like to share some information about MQTT topics and the best practice to use it. In our previous video, we discussed what topic is. The MQTT broker uses the topic of a message to decide which client receives which message. Also, in our last videos, we used single word topics such as temperature to receive and send messages. But this is not a good practice if you have hundreds of devices at different places. The best practice is to use topic separator and create different topic levels. Forward slash is used for separating topic levels. For example, you have two homes with three rooms and each room has two temperature sensors. We cannot use topics such as temperature 1, temperature 2, as it will be hard to differentiate them. So we will create topic level like this. Home 1:room 1:temperature 1. For temperature 2 of room 1 of home 1, we can write home 1:room 1:temperature 2, and we will use a separator between them. Similarly, we can create different topic levels, so it will be easy to differentiate the data. Another thing to mention is wildcards you can use in topics. For example, we were using the exact name of the topic in our previous videos to subscribe to the topic. But if we have hundreds of devices, there will be so many lines of code just to subscribe to the topics. So we have wildcards for the single level for which we use plus sign. Here is an example. If we subscribe to home1 separator plus separator temperature 1, it will subscribe to temperature 1 of all the rooms in the first house. These are the topics it will subscribe to. The second wildcard is for multi-level and for which we use hash. Here is an example. If we subscribe to home1 separator hash, it will subscribe to all the temperature sensors available in all the rooms of house 1. Here are the examples. That was a short description about the MQTT topics. Here are a few more tips to define topics. Never start with leading forward slash. The green one is the correct, but the red one starts with leading forward slash is not a good practice. Never use spaces in topics. Keep the topic short and concise. Only use ASCII characters. Don't use any non-printable characters. Don't just subscribe to hash. It will subscribe to all the topics, but it's not a best practice. Use specific topics, not general one, as it will help you to differentiate between the data. So, now let me ask you a question. What is the difference between local MQTT broker and cloud MQTT broker? And here is the answer. Local MQTT broker is used when you need to connect devices within the network. For example, in the last video, our ESP8266 and Raspberry Pi were connected to the same network. and MQTT broker on a cloud is available to be accessed from the internet. We can use cloud MQTT broker in order to control or send messages between devices from anywhere around the world. Talking about cloud services, there are many MQTT clouds available in the market. But for this video, we will be using RYC 1001 IoT Cloud Services by React Technology, which is built on stable AWS services. React Technology is the sponsor of this video. Here are few reasons to use React's RYC 1001 IoT Cloud. It is built on stable AWS services. It has database to store, search, and modify data. It is low-cost access to the cloud. So, the next thing is, how are we going to use RYC 1001 IoT Cloud in our project? Here is the operation flow. We will first need to buy the RYC 1001 cloud and they will provide us with some credentials. Then we can set MQTT URL and communication port. Then we will set username, password and client ID. Then we will connect and login. ESP8266 will subscribe to API separator command separator your network ID separator hash to receive command to turn on and off LED. ESP8266 will read DHT11 data and publish it on API separator request. Python, which we are using to test our publish subscribe, will subscribe to API separator notification separator network ID separator hash to receive DHT11 notifications published by ESP8266 on topic API separator request. In Python, we will publish the command for turning on and off the LED on the topic API separator request. Another question arises. ESP8266 is publishing data on API/request, which is received by Python on the topic API/notification. And Python is publishing the data on the same topic, which is API/request. But ESP8266 receives the data on a different topic, API/command. So the question is, how? The answer is, because the message format for both is different and the data we send and receive is in JSON format. Obviously, we can use the same single word topic and publish and subscribe to the same topics to receive data. But that is not secure and we will not be able to get the benefits of the database. ESP8266 publish message in this format. You can notice that action is notification. So the message published by ESP8266 will be added in the database of the cloud and it will publish a message on the topic API/notification and Python will receive it because it is subscribing to it. Similarly, the message we are publishing from the Python is in this format. And here the action is command. So the message will be received by ESP8266 in the topic API/command and similarly the data will be added to cloud. So now we have learned enough theory about the cloud. Let's dive into the practical. We will start by making the circuit. We will start by putting the DHT11 on a breadboard. And then we will put LED in the breadboard. DHT11 has three terminals. signal, VCC and ground. We will connect this signal with D1 of NodeMCU and we will connect the positive of LED on D2. The VCC of DHT11 will go to 3.3 volt and both the grounds of LED and DHT11 will connect on the ground pin of NodeMCU. You will find the circuit diagram in the blog that is given in the description. Now, let's write code for ESP8266. We already installed the PubSub client library, but we need to change a few things in the PubSub client.h. So, we will copy its data and paste it in the same folder so we can bypass it. So, we will first create a file PubSub client.h and paste the content of it, and we will change the max buffer size because the default is 128. And that will not allow us to receive large data. Also, make sure you set the right extension. Then, we will create a file for our Arduino code. And we will import a few libraries that we imported last time as well. Adafruit sensor and DHT for DHT sensor. ESP8266 Wi-Fi for ESP8266 Wi-Fi functionalities, PubSub client for MQTT, and Arduino JSON for parsing JSON data. Here is how you can download any library. Then, we are defining the pins and DHT parameters such as DHT type and delay which we will use. Then, we will import MQTT and Wi-Fi credentials such as SSID of Wi-Fi, password of Wi-Fi, MQTT server, MQTT username and password that you will get after buying the cloud. Client ID, which you should use as your MQTT username, plus 000N. N is index of device. For example, if the device is 12, you can write 0012. And we are defining the topic we will publish to. Then we will add some variables for using non-blocking delay. That means we will publish data after every 5 seconds and then create some variables to store the message we will publish and to read temperature and humidity. Then we have set up the MQTT and Wi-Fi clients. Now we will make void setup and loop functions. In the setup function, we will first start serial communication so we can see the results on serial monitor and then initialize the DHT sensor. Then using DHT library function, we can read data from sensor. We will define pin modes and set the LED off at start, and also we will call the function setup Wi-Fi, which will help us to connect to Wi-Fi. Now let's define the setup Wi-Fi function, in which we will connect to Wi-Fi, and if it is not connected, it should wait for Wi-Fi to be connected. After defining the function, we will set the MQTT server and callback function, which we will come back to later. And in the loop, we will write condition if MQTT is not connected or disconnected, reconnect, and we will define the reconnect function. In which we will write a conditional loop that if MQTT is not connected, it should retry after every 5 seconds. Otherwise, it can subscribe to the topic. Then we will write code for non-blocking delay in loop body and write code for reading temperature and humidity from the sensor. Then we will write a message that will be published in JSON format. You need to put device ID, which you will get after buying the cloud. And we wrote the temperature and humidity values in the parameters, which will be read by the end device. Then we will convert the message to character array, because client.publish accepts character array, not string, and we will publish that on the topic API request. Then we will define the callback function, which will be called when we will receive any message, in which we will convert the data we received in JSON, and then we will deserialize it, then read the parameters, in our case the status of LED. If status is 1, turn on LED, otherwise LED should be off. In the end, we can write serial commands for printing the data on the serial monitor. Now, let's select our device and communication port and upload the code. I have made a graphical user interface using Python to test the code. I will explain that in the upcoming videos. You can see the values changing on the graphical user interface. Now, let's see if LED is working. And it works. Thank you for watching. If this video was helpful, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon. And I will see you in the next video. You can post your questions in the comment. I will try to answer them.